continue with our winter series lectures. Our first speaker this morning will be Dr. Samuel Salas. He will be giving a lecture on the Catholic Church.
Good morning, Gus.
Good morning.
It's a pleasure to stand before you and testify some of the things I learned. Through all these years, I've been attending IDMR and different schools. I've been visiting Los Angeles, and I was raised in 1040 Grand Los Angeles when our founder was with us in the flesh. And I attended another schools, and I went to a Denver, Colorado convention in 1973. And there is no other place you can learn the truth about Yahweh, the creator of this stellar universe. The things you see and the things you don't see is the creator of all things. All things in plural. But there is a key. How you can open the, we can say, the truth. The key is this. If you really, really understand and investigate the true name of the Creator, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, if you accept those names, for sure, with your investigation, you don't have to be, investigate too. It's not too difficult. It's easy. So easy. The most easy way is going to the library and look a dictionary in there, and you can find Yahweh is the true name of our Creator.
That's right.
As we have written in this book, the name of the Father, the name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Spirit. The world have problem. Even if they know those three names, they still have problem to understand the nature. How he make himself the creator of the whole thing. Let me explain. Yahweh, nobody seen the Father as you read in the Bible. Because he's pure spirit. But we can see with the spiritual eyes the positive attributes of him, which are written in this chart. Wisdom, intelligence, wisdom, knowledge, love, beauty, foundation, just and power, strength. That's the only way we know the Father and pure spirit. But for us to understand him, he came down into a manifestation. Mm-hmm. As we know him as Elohim. The only son and the first son of Yahweh without flesh of God. But he can be seen in a vision and a revelation. Two ways. Now, the Holy Spirit, Yahshua the Messiah, after the creation became to exist in the year 4000 of science, Adam and Eve were here. Yahshua the Messiah, Yah, you can read it, Yah, the masculine portion, and we, the feminine portion. Now, Yahshua, Shua means salvation or savior. When you understand those three names and accept of the, as the true names, automatically you became baptized. Because this man told the apostles to go and preach around the world, knowing at that time, go and baptize in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And those are the names.
Okay.
And true. So this is the key. If you accept those three names, you don't have trouble listening to the rest.
That's right. That's right.
Now, that key had to be reflected in the founder's vision. In the year 1931, he said, and he claimed, he had a vision first. Then, after, he had a revelation.
Yes.
He told some of the people in that time to make a chart for him, explaining what he saw in his vision. And after that, he started to explain what the vision was about. So he revealed what was revealed to him,
right,
to us. This is why you have this chart as a key figure.
Right.
For the camera, it's move away. This vision, the founder, Henry Clipper Finley, had is everything you read in the Bible is right here in these charts. There is nothing is in the Bible, it's not here. It's the whole thing. And but those charts have to be explained. And I don't have the ability to explain those things. Is the Holy Spirit. If he allowed this vessel to say or reveal things to you, can be possible. But I is only a vessel. Let me talk to you. It's not about me. But sometimes you have to bring your background to know
right,
who is talking to you.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I don't like to talk to my personal life because it's beautiful, but it's the ways, the road is so long and you go through a lot of experience. But that builds your personality. Mm-hmm. That's you. My country where I came, the country where I came from is Mexico. To give you the location close to 2 hours far from Puerto Vallarta. You probably, everybody know about Puerto Vallarta. Where Richard Burton and Elizabeth Taylor make a movie, The Night of the Iguana. After that movie, that place became so popular. Everybody from all over the world go and visit that place. And it's beautiful. I have a lot of relatives living there. And the last 2 years, I've been visiting my aunts, my uncles, 95, 86, 82 years old, they still live. My father, cousins, sisters. And I lost my father when I was 2 years old. And we were three brothers, and we came north little by little. With relatives, aunts, uncles, we have relatives all over to the border. So it was a hard time for us. A 2 years old boy, my grammar education is only 6 years. That's all I was able to attend. Because I had to start working at 13 to support the family and try to walk it life. 20 years old, I have a contract from the United States to work in a farm labor. This is the way I was able to come to this country. At year I was 20, was 1963. When they killed the President of the United States, John F. Kennedy. About 2 months after I arrived to this country, they killed him. I remember, it's my memory. 63, 64, 65, 67, I became a U.S. resident. I spent all the money I accumulate with those 2 years working here. But I made my work here. I was 23, and I was, as they call, there is nobody illegal, but they call legal with, you know, papers, because the world is, nobody is illegal. The world, you have, the people have the right to seek and look for happiness. Anywhere in the world. Okay, so I am so happy. Yahweh bless me, take care of me, and take me out of dangers. Let me just tell you, I work in the fishing work and the boat in the California Ocean for 1 year, not knowing how to swim.
Whoa. Oh my gosh.
I was 18 then. I was looking for something better all the time. When I was 13, 14 to 18, I was a salesman, house to house, selling clothes. And I was doing good. I was able to make a house for my mother and support my brothers and my mother. I stopped helping my mother when I get married. At that time, I already fixed residence for them in the United States.
Good job, sir.
so I don't have to worry about them no more. And he protect me so well, I never been arrested. I never been convicted.
Okay.
I know, because I did little things I can be put, stuck it out, but I didn't. Sometimes I say, what happened? Things so, you know, clean? Well, this is Yahweh's work. Now, yes, I am telling you, I am so happy and so glad and so thankful to my Creator. And one of the things I really am more, because I have the understanding who is running the show.
Right.
Listen, let me go back to the names again. See, the element who give life to animal kingdom, the forest, the plants, and the animal, is water. Without water, life and other planet cannot be or cannot exist. They seeking for water in the moon and Mars and so many places. They say, they claim. I doubt. I even doubt they've been in the moon. Why? So simple. They've never been there no more. They say they went once. Why not twice? It's closer than Mars. But some people believe. I don't. Water, let me go back. Water is the element to give life in this physical place that we call Earth. We say Yahweh is symbolized with a cloud. As you can see this chart, around is a cloud to symbolize Yahweh is all and all. And the elements you find in a cloud are all the elements in existence are in the cloud. Yeah, water. We find water in the form of steam, a cloud. And shape and form as water. With these symbols, you can understand, even if you don't know how to read and write. And you have a cubit here, as we can say, eyes, one manifestation, second manifestation, and third manifestation. Mm-hmm. In the same element, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Very good.
Invisible.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Visible, solid, physical. One, two, three. It's going according to the pattern. One, two, three. Nothing in this world escape the pattern. Now, in this teaching, we say nothing escape the pattern. We have 6,000 years since Adam and Eve became to exist. When Yeshua the Messiah was crucified, or when he born, or in reality, he didn't born. Mm-hmm. He just appeared, but looks like he born.
Very good. Excellent.
He was all the time, and he's been all the time.
There you go.
Yeshua the Messiah. Now, you know, this thing is so deep. Sometimes you want to go one way, but you go another way. But let me see what, because the only teacher there is the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
The founder say this in one of the lectures. I never teach you nothing.
Good.
The teacher is the Holy Spirit. He say that. That means he didn't take no credit for what he was showing to him. Mm-hmm. Because in reality, we are a vessels. We are Yeshua with a name, because that name reflects our personality. Mm-hmm. We are special in a way. And I will let me explain you this thing. Don't get confused or don't take, oh, so special now. We are special for this reason. It's, we are unique. Nobody is exactly like another one.
That's right.
Even we are over 7 billion people in this earth, and none of us are exactly equal physically and also in the way of thinking. Mm-hmm. You might be, or you might have more knowledge than I have in certain things. And another one probably have less. Mm-hmm. But this is the way Yahweh purpose each one of us. Mm-hmm. See, I say Nazi escape the pattern. I love to go into this tabernacle. I seeking for more details to try to find the last insignificant thing, because they look insignificant, but they mean something.
Right.
It's a heavenly thing. Nothing escaped the pattern. 1, 2, 3. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, we have in this creation, we have atoms, and we have organic cells. The atom is 1, 2, 3. Proton, neutron, and electron. Now the cell is a nucleus, nucleolus, and cell body. Mm-hmm. In my mind, I know in Spanish, but I had to work so hard to bring in English. I translate, but thanks to Yahweh, he bring to my remembrance.
Right.
Let me go back a little bit. That way, you see. When I was invited to attend IDMR, in 1971, I say to my friend, okay, let's go and see what they talk about. I get in, sit down the chair, start to listen. I listen to things I never heard before. And I became captive of this teaching. Captive. And I still remember as yesterday. Looks like the time didn't move. But showing here is moving.
Yeah.
I was 26 then. A young and single young man. And we deteriorated in the time. But that happened to everybody. We are, like they say, dogs passing through in this life. Like pigeons passing through in this life. We only have one opportunity to know if Yahweh really is and actually exists. And that is the first aim of the Institute of Divine Metaphysics research. The second aim is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood in humanity, in Yahshua the Messiah, without distinction of nationality, creed, sex, or color. To investigate the unexplained spirit law, so-called law of nature, and the power latent in man. To promote the study of the scriptures, comparative religion, psychology, philosophy, modern practical, and occult science. I heard the founder say this, and I never forgot. We have so much problem understanding the science are not occult. What about the ones are occult? We probably have more problem to that, for try to find out more about the occult. Just deal with the ones that are not. If you go to the occult side, you can be trapped there. There's a lot of people doing that. And this time, see, this teaching, it's so beautiful. Like I say, you can go in different ways. It's 4,000 years of history. In some places, they got stuck in Aramaic translation. And they cannot come out of there. They cannot. They stir it. It's so beautiful and so deep and so many details. But they are stuck in here. The most you try to explain them, there is a veil cover their faces. If there is purpose for Yahweh to let them know, let that happen. If they never embrace the truth, that's purpose that way.
That's right.
Nothing you can do about. See, When this man born, Yahshua the Messiah, the world changed. Even time we live in now, 2015, start counting. We are on the 2015, they start working 24. But there is 4,000 years before that. It came to fulfill? Yes. It came to fulfill. Let me give you a little proof, so simple, can a blind or whatever cannot hear. The creation of the world according to Moses' vision is very important. The creation of the world was shown to Moses in a vision. Let me emphasize and repeat this. The creation was made in a click of an eye. Right. The showing to Moses in a slow motion with a little details. That way it can tell these seven elders to write it down. The way he see it. Because they were a witness. And the ones translate the Bible later on, they also were 70. People were very well educated. Now, when Moses see the creation, he see, and the second time, because Moses take it took three trips to the mountain, Sinai and Arabia, and the Sinai Peninsula. The second trip he went in there, he see Yahweh Elohim, because he is the creator of the physical creation. Who is Yahweh in a shape and form of a man.
That's right.
And the fourth day of the creation, he placed the S-U-N and the moon and the stars and the planets and the universe. But this is the point. This sun, the fourth day, reflect the sun, the 4,000. You can see this, you can call correlation. Correlation are very important because it's knowledge. Without knowledge, you cannot have understanding.
That's right.
Impossible for a man. When you wanna become a doctor, lawyer, or whatever profession you want to, you get to read a lot of books. Have the information. Otherwise, you only can become a bricklayer. Because you need all that information, if you want to be a doctor, you have to know how the physical body functions.
Yeah.
But you get to devour, as we call, books and books. And you have to pass the test with the questions. This is why correlations are very important, because it's knowledge from Yahweh who give you the tools to to understand him. See, the world, when I say the world, I mean people not ever hear about this teaching of IDMR. They have a wrong date about his birth.
That's right.
180 degrees wrong.
Wow.
The circumference have a 360 degrees or divide 360. 90 or 90 give you 360. One chord. 90 degrees. But they went all the way, like walking this way, and they just turn this way.
There you go.
That's 180. Let me prove you. Let me give you a little history about this thing. It's very important. When I first start coming to IDMR in Los Angeles, as the way they call it in English, I went ballistic. Well, I pronounce this word ballistic because my understanding is a bullet going, phew! I went to Mexico with the charts. They give me a chart, but this big 35 by cardboard. And then Los Angeles, and I paint with a crayon and colors some, because they are the pictures already there. But I work in it to make it more visible. Mm-hmm. They were in blue, like a blueprint. Mm-hmm. And I went to Mexico. Oh, I thought it's well, with that little knowledge I have in a few months. It was enough for me to go and fight the world,
right,
and put the church down.
Right.
Come on.
I have the stands, and I have those charts. I have this one, and I have Yahshua Messiah, and which one? Oh, I have this one. The man made in the image of Elohim by the pattern of the tabernacle. I have this one. I have twin. And I, you know, in Mexico, they have a strong tradition where they have a church, so-called church. They pick up a place where there is the church here. Let me see if I can. Like that bell right there all the time. See, they have a park in here where everybody go and have a break with trees and flowers, you know, a little park. But all the time there is a church in there. They have seats in here in the park. In almost every city, small city or big city, this is the way they plan. They start with the church in the park, and then a little house around, and they start planning the streets and everything.
Mm-hmm.
I just put my stand in the pitch right. And I start teaching about Virgin Mary. Virgin Mary, according to them, is the mother of Yahshua the Messiah. Mm-hmm. But to them, she is still a virgin.
Mm-hmm.
After over close to 500 years, they still worship her as a virgin. And I explained them, she had more son with Joseph after the Messiah came to appear. Say, this is the way I had, or have come out from Virgin Mary loins. I told them she was not virgin no more.
That's right.
But if you say that 50 years ago, you probably been crucified, right? I'm like him. The things changing little by little. After the Protestant arrived to my town, where I raised in the border, because my family, we came from the south to the borders of the United States. I went to school right there in the border. Sonora, San Luis, River Red or Rio Colorado, where the River Colorado go to the Californian Ocean, right there. So I tell them, Virgin Mary, she don't supposed to be worshipped. The reason, she was Yahweh used her to bring his son, Yahshua the Messiah, because he was fulfilling. He was fulfilling Elohim. And also, he was fulfilling Adam, the first man.
That's right.
If Adam was the first man on earth, and he was called the second Adam, the similarities how they born should be the principle almost equal. Saint Adam was created from the dust of the earth. The air was virgin.
That's right. That's right.
Because never before gave a birth to another man. This is why Virgin Mary had to be young. For nobody chased her before. And having even Joseph, the angel appeared to him. He said, don't touch her. She will have a baby, but I know you don't have nothing to do with her. Please don't even go there. Leave it alone. And he understood because an angel appeared to him. He obeyed. And also, she was told, he will have a baby. And look at this. The angel appeared. Let me take a little step over here. You can point the camera right there. And I have a few working things in here. I was collecting some papers here. This is according to them, the mother of the Savior. They call Virgin Mary. Before going a little further and how he came, let me explain you about how she became so powerful in a country where there is 120 million people, Mexico. And after that, all Central and South America. They believe her having so much power, they give her so much power. But there's a trick in there. I read the history. I never was a fully Catholic myself, because when you are moving to one town to the next and going north, or like an exodus, you don't have so much time to going to churches they have in Mexico. So I never was, I attend, and let me be honestly to you, I can say I counted with my two hands the time I attend the Catholic Church. One time my mother gets sick, so I see other, everybody go and ask for things. He said, I better go and ask for my help of my mother. Oh, please, Virgin Mary, please. I want my mother to be okay. And sometime friend of mine invite me. He was very deep in Catholic. When I went there a few times, I see so many statues everywhere. Saint Saul, Saint Peter, Saint John, Saint this, Saint that. I probably count, but more than a dozen. This size. Some little smaller. They have a, they call Jesus Christ. They know as a tall as a man. They call him Jesus Christ. You know, after we've been in, well, with a few days you being IDMR, you became so knowledgeable, it's impossible to be the true name.
That's right.
And the proof is so simple and easy. As the moderator, our brother Reginald Thomas, all the time give a big, beautiful explanation, the introduction. And after he made the introduction, we can really, really go home. Mm-hmm. Because he go into more, more beautiful and more important details of everything. The moderation. See, let me go back to Virgin Mary. Virgin Mary, see, this is very important to me. I think also to the rest of the world, because the rest of the world probably never heard this thing I want to say. Mm-hmm. And the year, history is written right here. In the back. In Spanish. 1474, a man called Juan Diego born. And in the year 1531, she appeared into him. And this way, he was crossing a little hill, and a beautiful lady called him Juan Dieguito, Juan Dieguito. He called Little, and he called his name Juan or John. Little John Dieguito. Listen, I have a message for you. So he said, go to the priest and tell him I want he to build a church for me here. So he went over and talked to the priest. A lady appeared to me. She said, he's the father of God. She wants a temple to be worshipped. Oh, the priest said, it's an history. I have a book also with all the details. And now what? And the Aztec language. Half of these books are in Aztec language.
It's upside down.
Oh. all the details how that happened. Aparicio. Go and tell the priest, he went over and told him, oh, a lady appeared to me, she wanted to be the temple be built. Oh, go away. So he went, he had to go to his house crossing that place. He went back one more time. And the lady, what happened? When he gave him, tell you, priest, I want a sure bill right here for worshiping. That way I can intercede for you, take care of you, and protect you. He went, well, bring me a sign. A sign? Yeah, okay. And the lady appeared to him one more time and said, oh, the priest want a sign. Cut those flowers in there and put in your poncho. And do not open till you ask you for sign and you open your poncho. So when he went over and say, I bring the sign of the lady appearing to me, the guard, the priest live in a palace, right there. So they don't let him go in to see the priest. But when they try to open that thing, the flowers turn into a sewing flowers in the poncho. They cannot grab it. Mm-hmm. When, according to the book, they say, oh, it might be a sign. Let it go in. So he went in, but they say he went into his knees in the palace to sit talk to the priest. When I read that, I bet you the previous times he went into his knees. This is why. The Spanish conquered Mexico in the year 1531. But the Spanish get into Mexico City, who was, the name was Tenochtitlan, was in the 1521. They took the Spanish 10 years to conquer this, the Aztecs. They were good warriors, but they don't have the weapons, the paddle. And the Spanish, they already have arquebuses, rifles in there. That called that time, arquebuses. So they eventually, 10 years, they lost. And they lost the war and deposed the weapons. Every religion, every tribe deposed the weapons in the year 1531. And the same year, Virgin Mary appeared. You had to be a cuckoo to accept that version, that history. Now, going back to the priest. When the priest asked him, did you bring the sign I asked you? Yes. Show me. So here the poncho here. He put the poncho there. He got like this. He put the end and the flowers fall. Then come back and stamp it in the poncho as a picture. Mm. That picture, the original, they still have it. And the church of Mexico City, the Basilica of Mexico City, they still have the original. But 20 years ago, the priest hired someone to go and touch up because the color they were deteriorating. I gotta give. This is the way it looks now. But even was touch up. It was something holy appearing. It never can
fade.
the color never fade away.
Very good. Right.
And this is the way they paint now. More colorful, as a brand new. And they claim that's the mother of all the Mexicans and Latin America. And believe me, those Aztecs and all those tribes around, they were so religious in their way with the idols, because they have an idol for everything, from the sky, for the water, the plants, for everything they have an idol. No different from the rest of the world.
Right.
Mm-hmm. In Europe, they did the same thing. Now, when the Spanish conquest in the year 1531, they changed the religion they had to embrace this one. And it was so easy for this reason. They have hundreds of virgins in Spain and in Portugal. And friends, they all have churches. I have books, and I see, and they have a similarity, the way they paint over there with a brush, close to the Virgin Mary paint. The same style. Now, there is a little water. Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, there is a little bottle right here. Thank you. Thank you. They have a, but the Aztecs did not accept the Spanish virgins, because the treatment the Spanish did to the Aztecs was very severe. They put them to work right away. Mm-hmm. In other words, they were slaves. Uh-huh. From one day to the next, they were slaves, where they deposed their weapons. So they say, okay, this is your Virgin del Carmen, the Virgin of this, the Virgin of that. The Aztecs don't want it, because they relate those virgins to them. And they say, well, we better think, oh, what about if we make a virgin related to them, with a brown skin, no difference. And besides this thing, where the man Juan Diego the Gil, he went into, it was a temple of the only women they have as a god, worship a woman. The only one, all were males. Her name was Tonantzin. It's right there. Tonantzin. So the lady asked to build a temple on top of the temple or the pyramid of Tonantzin to relate that one with them. After the Aztecs relayed her to their people, the rest, the other virgins start coming, they start accepting, saying they worship one, well, they start worshiping the rest. But you can read, this is a calendar. They call calendario in Mexico. They give you 365 days, right here, and every day have a name or one saint. Saint Samuel, Saint Reginald, Saint Yo, Saint, everybody is a saint. And all those argue. It's a, they call it calendar. And they have a calendar too. Aztec calendar. And each little point of the calendar, the Aztec give a name according to where he born. So they relate everything. The Catholic, they were too smart how to convert people everywhere. People have a not good knowledge of this thing. Christopher Columbus, he never touched Mexico, Venezuela, or Central America. Mm-hmm. He only landed in the Caribbean islands.
That's right.
And the three trips he made, mm-hmm. he only went into Santo Domingo, mm-hmm. he went to the Port Principe, Cuba. His brother was killing Cuba because he mistreated the Cubans, the aborigines, and they killed him. That's history. Here in this country, they only teach you history they want you to know.
Not the real.
That's true.
They teach you how Mexico lost the five states, but they don't tell you how it happened. Mm-hmm. And they're really true. The last place they want to grab one time was Mexico, California, Mexico, and Sonora, where I came from. They lost the war thanks to an Indian, a Papago tribe, who threw an arrow and went into the powder place and burned and killed all the soldiers of the United States. The general was Henry Ackrad. Look in the computer, his name. Henry Ackrad, the year 1857. He was a senator of the Alta California, San Francisco.
Okay.
Well, let's change the gear. Let's talk about Yahweh. This was purpose also. Shannon.
Question.
Okay. Yeah. I wanted to know, and I think you went there, the Virgin of Guadalupe, is that the same Virgin Mary, but in a version in Guadalupe, or is it a different version?
It's the same one.
Okay.
The Mother of Jesus Christ. You know, the letter J never was in the Hebrew alphabet.
No.
As original Thomas tell us, never was, and there is none, in the Hebrew alphabet. The letter J was found or being used the 13th century, mm-hmm. and appeared in the English alphabet the 17th century. That means there is no such a name, Jesus, a little bit over 300 years before. Impossible. Now, the name of the Savior cannot be Greek, since he claimed, and also he born in the Hebrew land from a Hebrew family, and he claimed he was the king of the Hebrews and the rest, Hebrew and Gentiles too. He's supposed to have a Hebrew name, not a Greek. Jesus came from the idol or the god of the Greeks, Zeus or Jupiter. Zeus, and they say, Jesus. They use the J and they put Zeus in there. is possible. If you read in here, the name of the Father is Yahweh. His Son have to carry some portion of the name of the his Father, like the males in here. You have a son, and you are, your last name is Washington, or Williams, or John, whatever last name you have, he had to have to. Because your real name is not the first one, it's the second one. That's the family name. But if the family have 10 sons, they have to differentiate between those 10.
That's right.
Otherwise, the father calls and everybody runs to him. So this is why you have the first name and the second name, who is the real one. Mm-hmm. We have the son, Jah, who is the male portion of Yahweh. Shua in Hebrew means salvation or savior. And in other words, this is the meaning. Yahweh the Savior.
That's right.
Because this is the mystery that people cannot understand. He was the same coming down from invisible to visible and solid. The same spirit and three manifestations, and as I explain you the element water. 1, 2, 3.
Go ahead.
And I say before, he was, they call, the son of Yahweh, but his real name, as I explain you, is Yahshua, the Messiah. He came to fulfill the law and the prophecy. The law was given to them, and the prophecy, the prophets, let me mention a few, Isaiah and Jeremiah, they talk to the people in that time, in the year 700 and 800 BBY, or before the birth of Yahshua the Messiah, the liberator, a king will come and restore the kingdom. Because the kingdom was destroyed completely. They turned the back to this teacher, the one Yahweh gave to them to obey. It was a hard to keep it. No one was able to do so. All break this law. Besides this one, there were other ones. Total 613. If you miss one or you translate, make a translation one, you make the translation all.
That's right.
This is why every year in the Day of Atonement, they have to make three sacrifices. They make sacrifice every day. But those sacrifices, the high priest is not allowed to go to the most holy place. Only once a year, he went 3 times in there. It's very important. When you learn about this tabernacle, it gives you a lot of answers. Anything they tell you, you just put it right in.
That's right.
If it's not fit, it's not true. It was an ox, a ram, and 2 goats. Not just one. 2. The ox was there to purify the high priest, mm-hmm, because he also break the laws.
Right.
It was not perfect, impossible. I say all break the law.
Yeah.
It was not excluded. But he had to cleanse himself or take a shower. How? Sacrificing a bull, a big one. Because as he know, any little thing he did is big because he had more knowledge than anybody else. So the first sacrifice was for him, high priest. He went inside, and there is a lot of details here, but I want to make it short, that way I can advance. Mm-hmm. He went in there to the most holy place with the blood of the sacrifice of the bull, and he sprinkled 7 times. He came down and he took the blood of the ram. He did the same thing. He went, he sprinkled 7 times. Then he came down. There were 2 goats. Clean. But without a spot and blemish. Less, they say, 1 year old. Less than 1 year old. Less. Because that lambs, those 2 lambs don't have a desire for anything. Yes, if. They were too small. So they never have nothing to do. Without a spot and blemish and clean. So the high priest checked those 2 lambs real good. Mm-hmm. No spot and skin. Mm-hmm. Been doing nothing and no breaking bone. Mm-hmm. Complete. Those. But when there was a time to sacrifice the lamb, since there were 2, he had to choose one.
Right.
How? He had 2 stones, mm-hmm, in his garments, under the 12, the golden plate with the 12 stones. Each stone would present each of the 12 tribes, sons of Jacob. He got the 2 stones, Urim and Thummim. He rolled the dice, and the dice told him which one he had to sacrifice and which one he had to let it go. So he picked up the first one, and they told him, let this go away. And this one can take the sin of the people. Because that sacrifice of the lamb was for the sin of the people. Mm-hmm. The ram was for the cleansing of the sanctuary.
That's right.
Or the tabernacle. Everything had to be in order. One, two, three. And the last sacrifice, Lexi. The last sacrifice was the lamb. It was the third sacrifice. What time? 2 o'clock? When the Lord priest ignited the candles. 3 o'clock. And the first one, the bull, when there is no light there yet, because they ignition later, because the sun, this was facing east, the door, all the time. No matter where they go, this place where the brazen altar of the sin sacrifice had to face east all the time. So they have a light all the time there. Except when the sun was coming down.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
It was coming down. Like,
what are you, Adam?
Right there. Right there.
Oh, he. Mm-hmm. He came down. It was placed in the garden. It was not made in the garden. They were bison, gion, tigris, and Euphrates. Four rivers. Mm-hmm. And the Garden of Eden was right there. Four rivers. This is when you start honestly and with you all your heart worship and learning and want to know something about Yahweh, it can reveal things to you. It can reveal that you have to be sincere in your heart. You have to be, otherwise it cannot reveal nothing to you. You have to be sincere. And when some, whoever it is, start teaching this or polluting this teaching, it can go far, far every day away from the truth. We all have a veil in our faces. This is why you cannot see what is in front of your nose. You cannot see your nose. And it's so close to your eyes. That veil, the one can move it away, is Yahshua the Messiah. As the only one. See, the founder say this: I am the only man have that vision and that revelation, the only man. But he was saying that. But he say also, I never taught you nothing. Mm-hmm. If you understand what he means, he's the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. Because man is dead. You know. We all ignorance.
That's right.
Retarded. How many times we listen to the moral lesson? As we know. We memorize that? We are slow thinking. That retarded means. Mm-hmm. We cannot have it in once. You have to have a small, little by little, mm-hmm. according to its purpose. I am being purposed to be here. Mm-hmm. You are purposed to be here too.
That's right.
Some, we are all teachers, but we know the reality. I will explain you. But he used each of us for his purpose to tell the truth, detail by detail, and different manners.
That's right. That's correct.
You can be engineer, and you can apply this teaching in the engineering way. A doctor, you can go into details in a physical, biological way. And wherever you are, mathematician, also. Everything fit the pattern and the source of Yahweh became just one. Mm. Where everything came from? Mm-hmm. Pure spirit. And everything go to the place came from. Mm-hmm. Look. I pick it up. I cannot let it there. I have to put it back where it belongs to.
Okay.
That's proven the theory.
Very good.
See, every time I come, especially, there is three places at them, Fontana, Pomona and Ontario. This place has something very special for me. This is a learning place. It's a learning place. Other places are stuck in different things. Time's flying.
Okay.
Some places they worship the man, mm-hmm. Henry Clipper Kinley, mm-hmm. and he said not to. This way he hide.
There you go, Doc.
The time he born. He don't want to be worshipped from what he when he born. But we do, with our sincerity, a little investigation, we can find out. But that doesn't lead us to nowhere, but at least we have a knowledge. And what day of the year he appeared into us. Adam. Like I say, they were four rivers. Mm-hmm. Tigers, Everett, Bison, and I forgot the other one.
Euphrates.
Okay. It was placed there naked. No clothes. Why? The temperature was so beautiful, you don't need a clothes to feel good. And those days, a little children, you have to dress in because it can be cold, can be hot. But adults, we are dressing for another reasons. Because he was naked, placed in the garden. Mm-hmm. The climatologic state of the earth should be exactly as when he born or appear. The people take care of the lambs and the goats, pastors or shepherds, they work with the animals in the field. In December, they cannot do that. The snow is about this high from the ground. They have to dig. And they have a lot of presents for the little baby Joshua inside. So we have fish and fruits. Besides that, three wise kings, they follow a star.
That's right.
Because in those days, astrology take a part of life, people's life. They know so much of astrology, they divide the stars, the biggest stars, into animals and other artifacts and give them a name. And we have the zodiac, called zodiac. It was a division of the stars, and they used to go and thinking those zodiac signs can predict future. So that word, but when the three wise men see the star, I never read this thing, but probably an angel told them, go to Bethlehem, what the little city where Joshua the Messiah came from, Virgin Mary, lines. So they have a walk for probably months till they reach that place with presents of gold, myrrh, and other precious silver things. They took, the Hebrew took all those things out of Egypt to this tabernacle. So he just appeared and have all that gold and silver and mirror. See, I jumping from one place to another one.
You're doing all right.
But when they see looking for a place and they were the king Herod, Antipas, the son of the old another Herod, who was the father of the second. He said, where the king is born? Oh, a king is born, yeah, and here in your land. Oh, I didn't know, but go and look for him, and when you find him, come over and tell him where is he, that way I can go and worship, you know, worship him. And he called the high priest and asked him, hey, and your books you have, where the new liberator or the new king of the Hebrew will born in this time? They went to Jeremiah. Oh, here. Because Jeremiah had two revelations, a good one and a bad one. It was revealed to the Judah people will be taken captive to Babylon. He prophesied that. They didn't like him for doing that. But nevertheless, when Judah fall under Nebuchadnezzar, who was the king of Babylon, he spared his life. Let us go free. Because he knew, he predicted he will win the war. So he went to Egypt and never know, nobody know him, what happened to him. He disappeared for history. But he was spared his life and the king of Babylon. Now when Herod cannot find Joshua the Messiah, because he wait for the three kings right. Come over to him. Since they and when they didn't come and tell him the news where he's born, he said, oh, those kings fooled me, because they knew they can read, they were wise. Yeah. They can see in the eyes of the king. Because that king, I think, It has some of the sun be killed because he don't want competition with the kingdom.
Right.
So when that happened, the king, the 12 wise kings then come to him and say, okay, some of the soldiers go and slaughter all the male boys 2 years under and go to this place. He born right there. In Bethlehem, around Bethlehem, the soldiers kill every. But by that time, Mary and Joseph, they already in their way to Egypt.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because an angel appeared to them and told them, hey, woman, and you come when I call you. Mm-hmm. So after Herod the Great, Herod, Antipas, Herod the Great was the father, died 4 years later, they were free to come out of Egypt. I not say they did before he was 12, but he probably did. Mm-hmm. But appeared in the synagogue when he was 12.
Mm-hmm.
Appeared in the synagogue. Because the Bible say Joseph and Mary attend the synagogue before, after they come out of Egypt. So, it was 12 and talking to all the high knowledgeable high priests and low priests, and they were stunned about the knowledge he had and being 12. He was still was a little boy because in that time, 13 was considered an adult. So he appeared when he was 30 years. John the Baptist, he was baptizing Hebrews.
Right.
And with water in the Jordan River.
That's right.
Repent. He asked for repentance. And whoever repent, he baptized him. And when he see Yahshua the Messiah coming, this is the man I was talking to you about. Was coming after me. I baptized you with water. But he baptized you with the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. He was fulfilling this law. When they finished fulfilling that law, he fulfilled everything. Mm-hmm. He fulfilled everything when he was crucified. Everything would be. That's why we don't have to go by Moses' law.
That's right. That's right.
We have to know how that function.
Right.
But we don't have to follow the way
right.
they did.
That's right.
Because this law is not different from this one. In one way, this is spiritual. It's the same, but this is physical. They didn't understand spiritual things then. They cannot be there. It's another age. Three dispensations. Before the flood, after the flood, and present age.
Very good.
2,000 years each take us to the present time, 6,015. And time went so fast. I don't even touch the tabernacle as I want to, but that's Yahweh's purpose. thank you. Thank you very much for putting your attention and your time. And I am so glad Yahweh bring things he revealed to me, to my remembrance. And with this, I say thank you and hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We want to truly thank the Father for allowing us to hold class this morning, and we hold classes every Tuesday from 7:30 to 9:30, and Sunday mornings from 11 to 1. And beginning the first Friday in February, we will start having classes on Friday on a regular basis. So any announcements? All donations will be accepted by our treasurer, Dr. Irene Ramirez.
Oh yeah, anybody that wants today's class, $5.
See, can away with your $5. So come back again and study with us. Bring your friends and all your enemies and stand for the doxology. Now to him that is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the Lord, I am my Savior, to God, the Messiah, sovereign. With all glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before all time, now and ever. Let us all say, Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where is it about? Where is it about?